There's sort of two separate points you're making there. The first is that it's not really fair to compare to Norway, Denmark and Finland, and actually you think comparison with the UK or Netherlands or Belgium is more appropriate. I mean, are you saying then that this whole question of lockdown or no lockdown, the fact that Sweden uniquely in Europe didn't impose a lockdown, is not even relevant? Are you claiming that that is not the reason for the difference between Sweden and other Scandinavian countries?
I think we need to look at that in the long term, but I'm not sure that it's as easy to say that the lockdown will make the difference and no lockdown will make give you another result. And in many ways, we have had a very stringent lockdown in Sweden. I mean, we have cut down on movement in society quite a lot. We have, for example, compared how much we move around, how much we travel in the Scandinavian countries. And the decrease of travel is as big in Sweden as in our neighboring countries. We look when we ask the mobile operators to give us data on the movements. So in many ways, the voluntary measures we put in place in Sweden has been just as effective as the complete lockdown has been in other countries. So I don't think that complete lockdown is the way to go for all countries. You might be able to achieve the same kind of results with other means and maybe voluntary means. And I think that the rapid decline in cases we see in Sweden right now is another indication that you can actually get this the number of cases down quite a lot in a country without having a complete lockdown. But at the same time, once again, we have to look at the draconian measures that we're talking about. Are they going to produce even more deaths by other means than the disease in itself? And somehow we need to take that discussion. What is it that we're actually trying to achieve? Is it a better public health as a whole, or is it trying to suppress COVID-19 as much as possible?
Do you think Sweden will be better ready for them because of higher degrees of immunity than other countries that have had less infections so far?
Yeah, I've got that question before. I'm trying to answer it, not to sort of say that we are better off completely, because of course we are also going to get hurt by it. But I think it's likely that those kind of resurgence, those kind of outbreaks, will be easier to limit in Sweden because there is an immunity in the population. I mean, all our experience with measles and other diseases shows that. I mean, we are getting into a similar situation as with measles, that we're going to have outbreaks, and we know that with a large immunity towards measles in a population, it's much easier to control the outbreaks than it is if you don't have an immunity in a population. And most likely that will also apply to this disease. We will see if the measures in place in different countries really can cope with that.
I see someone's trying to fish you out. Let me ask you one final question.
Yeah.
Which concerns masks.
So okay.
I was in Stockholm a few days ago, and pretty much nobody is wearing masks.
Hmm.
The restaurants are quite full, although the numbers are still being controlled. It seems a lot more like a normal city than other European cities. Why are you not encouraging or requiring people to wear masks?
For a number of reasons. I mean, one reason is that the evidence base for using masks in society is still very weak. And even if more and more countries are now enforcing them in different ways, most times in very, very small areas, not in the complete society, we haven't seen any new evidence coming up, which is a little bit surprising, I can say. So that's one reason. The other reason is everything tells us that keeping social distances is a much better way of controlling this disease than putting masks on people. And we are worried, and we get at least tales from other countries, that people put on masks and then they believe they can go around in society being close to each other, even going around in society being sick. And that, in our view, would definitely produce higher spread than we have right now.